I want to share with you guys some of the more intimate moments of my life. And the reason that I'm doing this is because I think that I've gotten away from living my life like an open book as much as I used to. And part of that comes from maybe a little bit of fear, maybe not so much. But I think that it's important for us to continue to share these stories, because not only does it allow for me to continue to document my life, but to deep dive into some of the things that has made me who I am today, right? And so, you know, one of the stories or one of the things that I've shared with people is that I've lost my virginity, or I lost my virginity at a very, very early age in my life. And I'm not necessarily proud of it. If I had to do it all over again, obviously I would have waited. I grew up in an environment in which, obviously, like most of us, peer pressure is a thing. And I'm not blaming it on that. However, I matured. I believe I matured a lot faster. And so I think that this is a topic of debate. And this is one of the reasons why I'm sharing this, is because it's one of those uncomfortable conversations. And I know that we'd rather bury it in the past, or, you know, with some stuff that we prefer to take with us to the grave. But, you know, I debate with myself about how much to share, because I don't know if this is an opportunity for me to be vulnerable in order to, you know, have more conversation, or if it's something that's actually not going to be beneficial at all, depending on the audience that then sees it and then react to it. But neither here nor there, we're already here. And I lost my virginity at a very early age. But let me back up a little bit, because it wasn't just that I lost my virginity at an early age, but I grew up really fast. And it was that I went through puberty very, very early in my life. I mean, so early that I was in elementary school, and by the time that I was in a sixth grade, I already had a beard, right? I didn't have a full beard, but I had, like, you know, hair growing out the bottom of my chin, peach fuzz. And I was really mature for my age. And that, I think part of it came from the fact that I had older brothers that I was around all the time. And I was born with, not born with, but I had, you know, three brothers. I grew up with three brothers. No sisters. I got a younger brother that's 6 years younger than me, and then I got two older brothers that are 6 and 7 years older than me. So essentially, you know, I'm the middle child. And, you know, combined with the fact that I was really, really rebellious when I was growing up, and that I grew up in a church, and I grew up in a really great environment, and I had great influences in my life, including my father and my mother, and a whole lot of uncles, and a great community of people. And even though I grew up in the inner city of Detroit, it was a little bit different, because, you know, we didn't feel like we were poor, if that makes any sense, right? Because we had money, but it was almost like you hood rich, like you the best of a, or you the big fish in a small pond. And when I grew up, it was really interesting, and I'll get into it in another day about, you know, the money that we had and lost and all of that type of stuff. But when I grew up, being a middle child, you always chased and looked after or gleaned certain lifestyle cues from your older brothers, right? And because my older brothers were 6 and 7 years older than me, and, you know, they were the men and they were of the hood and, you know, all of that other type of stuff, I had an opportunity to grow up really, really fast. When we grew up in the 90s, because I was born in the early 80s, in 82. And so by the time I hit the 90s, let's just say early 90, 91, 92, 93, believe it or not, it wasn't abnormal for us to go to the mall and me to be with my brothers. And we used to play this game called A Day Without a Number. And A Day Without a Number meant that, you know, every day in the summer, in the winter, the fall, no matter what, the idea of it was that you had to go up to a girl and get a number. And so very quickly and very early in my life, I've learned, you know, to throw away a lot of the things that prohibit guys today from approaching women. And when I say early in life, I'm talking about all the way in elementary school. Like, I was very confident. I had no problems with approaching people, let alone being around people and approaching women. and communicating more effectively than a lot of the people that you see happen, you know, communicating today, which probably even helps me when it comes to content creation and YouTube and things like that, because I was around a lot of older people that were incredibly outgoing, well-dressed, put together, knew how to communicate really, really well. And they had the best of both worlds in that, you know, they were street smart and they were surrounded by a great community of people with family that they came back to that, you know, encouraged us to do the right thing, right? And so like any young knuckleheads, of course, you know, they got into different things in the streets, but obviously they turned out well. I followed right behind them and I turned out well. And I think my younger brother was the best of all of us, because obviously, you know, you have a lot of time to be able to correct a lot of the mistakes that we made, and him being able to see how things played out with us and then how we had to recover from some of the stuff that we did. I think that he was the best of all of us. And so, yeah, we used to play this game called A Day Without a Number. And then that was an opportunity for us to go to the mall. And because they was older and they was driving, and by the time I was 10 and 11, they had their license. And, you know, we would go out to Northland Mall. If you're from Detroit, you know what Northland Mall is. We would hit the mall. We would hit Belle Isle. And obviously, even though I'm the youngest, they kept me around them. And then I seen all of their friends, and all of their friends seemed cool to me and all of that other type of stuff. And so I didn't get involved in the drugs. I didn't get involved in gangs. But my vice was women. And when I say women, even at a very early age, I was talking to a lot of older women. And it didn't help that, again, I matured really fast for my age, because at 11 years old, I had grew to be the exact height I am today, which is 5'7". And it's funny because I never even seen myself as short until I got on the internet, because it just wasn't a thing. You know what I'm saying? We just always operated in confidence. We never cared anything about that. And it was nothing for you to be able to chop down a tree, if you know what I'm saying. But I grew up to be 5'7", but I was 5'7" when I was 10, 11 years old. So they're like, man, you know, you growing up fast for your age and you got a beard. And, you know, I had confidence. And so, you know, me being around my older brothers, when I would go back to school or I would go back to my normal environment, even when I got into high school, I think that I operated with a supreme level of confidence, even to the point to where people would call it arrogance or they would call it being narcissistic. I didn't look at it that way. I still don't look at it that way. I look at it as being incredibly confident and standing on your principles and being a man. But I think that a lot of guys are so feminine today that they don't know what that means. But that's a whole nother conversation.